Welcome to Holy Cross Texas School, Bagru. Today I am here to show my love towards our green earth. In this, I have engaged my scholars so that they can learn each and every step of seed germination. How? When they will do each and every step of seed germination by themselves, by their hands. Now, let's have a look what they are going to do.
First, we will keep the pebble on the drainage hole. After that, we will fill the container with vermicompost. This is the mixture already prepared for you. In this, 40% vermicompost is there, 40% cock pit. What do you know? Do you know what is cock pit? It's the mixture that is made from the coconut shell. Okay, that was prepared, and 10% river sand is there in this, and 10% garden soil is there. So we will fill this container with this mixture. 3/4 of this container we will fill. Spread it carefully so that it will spread everywhere lightly. Now we will take this plate. In this, we will open this seed packet. This packet is of calendula seeds. Okay. First, while we are purchasing seeds, we should know that the seeds should be of good quality. This quality should be. Then also check the expiry date on this packet. Are they expired or not? But then check the date. And after, when you are opening this packet, see, it should be preferably of this aluminium foil. Okay, it should be wrapped in aluminium foil, because this aluminium foil helps in retaining the moisture. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Now we will open this packet in this plate. This is fungicide. Okay, this will help the seeds to grow properly. So any insect or anything waiting around will not harm it. Then we will put some in these seeds. We will mix, we will coat these seeds with this. And after that, we will spread evenly these seeds in this soil. Sprinkler. thing, we will cover it so that any outside air won't go inside. We will tie it with this thing. Germinate the seed.
Yes, ma'am.
Now you have to do how, as I have done.
Yes, ma'am.
Started observing that the attitude of the children started changing. When they saw, the seeds started sprouting out. When the seeds started germinating, when the first few leaves popped out, it created an inspiration that the children felt that, as many of them have shared that, I feel like as if I have given life to something.
So these children, right from sowing seed to transferring grown plants to watering, weeding, children are involved in all aspects of flower production. So the kind of bond they share with the flower, it's truly heartwarming to see it.
Students, as you have grown seeds that day, 20 days ago, now you can see little sprouting has been done, little small plant has come out. This process is known as germination. Germination is a process in which the seed develops as a small plant. Okay, as you know, there are three parts of a seed. The upside is known as seed coat, that is works as a covering, okay, to protect the seed. Inside, embryo is there, that is known as a baby plant, from which the plant grows into a new plant. And inside, seed cotyledons are also there that works as the food for the baby plant. When this germination process starts, it depends on three factors: water availability and the temperature for growth of seed and proper covering of sand. That as you covered these manures, you put there insecticide, many things you have put there for the good growth of the seed.
We see these flower saplings and feel they have grown well. Earlier, we didn't know how to maintain or take care of garden. Now, we know how to maintain our garden. There is a widespread water scarcity in the world. We also come to know that how we have to plant lot of trees and flowers to correct this.
This is not something that is done only by a few children, and these involve the project Green Hands. All the children of the school gets inspired when they see this. They also want to plant trees and flowers. A few students came to me directly and asked me how they could get involved in this.